back all the time.
Oh yeah, once again.
3, 2, 1, go.
Yeah.
We are back. For yet another Stogie review. And I can't really lean over and show you, but this time we're doing the Macanudo 1968.
That's the
Churchill.
The new one. Yep, Churchill.
7x49. So it's a nice size smoke.
Let's give it a nice cut and see what it's re-smokes like.
And as far as the wrapper and all that stuff, it is a the wrapper is Honduran San Agustin.
Havana seed. Binder, so it's a Honduran wrapper.
Yeah. Binder is Connecticut Habano. Filler, Dominican Republic, Nicaragua, and
Ometepe.
Which I've never heard of.
Ometepe.
And they say this is aged in Tercios.
Tercios, which I don't know actually what it is.
Yeah, I don't know what that is.
And charcoaled wooden barrels to further enrich the flavor. The blends are married with marries Dominican tobacco, Nicaraguan tobacco to a proprietary filler cultivated exclusively by General Cigar in the remote island of Ometepe.
Which I've never heard of until now.
But it's right off Nicaragua there. It belongs to Nicaragua, so.
I think I'm...
I got my
feet
cut on.
I'm doing standard scissors. And I get a good draw.
Yeah.
It's like a little resistance, but not much.
Mine is good. No resistance in mine.
And it smells interesting.
This very aromatic, very strong, rich flavor.
And it's pretty firm.
Yeah.
It's unlike a lot of Macanudos. I have like the vintage Macanudos.
Well, yeah, those are
very mild.
Pretty mild, yeah.
Not much.
Even the Jamaican, it's a mild
cigar.
You know,
the 1988s, the 1990s. Six or whatever, I don't remember. And then they have like a 2001.
Right.
Not much to them. But I'm not a big fan of them.
Me either.
So that I was
but this
happy
one,
when Macanudo came out with it.
I did smoke this one already, and I like it. So we're going to critique it today.
Yep. It's...
I'm going to fire it up.
It smells good. Want to spark this bastard up.
Very nice, right from the very beginning.
I'm off. So far, so good.
Yeah.
I'm lit.
Pretty nice taste here.
Yeah, so far it's fuller than any Macanudo I've ever smoked.
Mm-hmm.
I think their other lines are kind of lackluster.
Nice light. Peppery through the nose, not much.
It's got a nice band on it, and it looks good. It's a little veiny of a wrapper. I mean, it's rugged looking for a Macanudo, I guess you could say.
But very well constructed.
Yeah.
Very
absolutely.
Nice.
And I believe this has a triple cap.
It does.
So the construction is real nice. A little lumpy here and there, but I'm not complaining. And what's the price point on these? I can never remember.
This one is about $11.
Is it? Wow.
Yeah.
So a little pricey.
$10. Mm. $10 and the Torpedo is $11. Mm. But I'll tell you what, it's a very, very delicious taste right from the beginning.
Yeah, yeah.
It will continue to get very, very nice.
And of course, for formality reasons, standard water. Preparing up. I believe Ed's doing water as well.
Yep.
Your drink does make a difference, so. Yeah, as far as flavors, initial flavors, I'm going to take a puff. See if I can get anything off of this.
Yeah. Let me know what you're getting.
Hmm. little pepper. Slight. I don't know if it's a little earthy or not.
I thought I had a touch. Slight, very slight earth.
Like, at the end of the exhale, I thought I had a touch.
With a touch of cocoa, yeah.
And I missed the cocoa on that puff, but yeah. I'm sure it'll come to me.
Oh, yeah.
But it's pretty impressive so far for a Macanudo, because to me, they're beginner smokes, I don't know. I'm just not enthusiastic about Macanudos in general.
Right.
But this one so far is
Macanudo it's a good cigar.
They're good.
For the beginner.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
I noticed some people in the past, they smoke Macanudo all the time, mm-hmm. you know? So.
I know people who do that as well.
Yeah.
But this one is turning out better than anyone.
Yeah.
So far, it's better than other Macanudos I've tried. So it's looking promising. As far as being a nice, flavorful smoke.
Very, very nice.
Yep.
Yep.
Cool. I think we got all the formalities out of the way.
Yeah, it looks like it.
We did the binder, blah, blah, blah. Size, price.
Yep.
I guess we can...
And it's brand new in the market. It's, as a matter of fact, right here at my shop, October 3rd, I'm having the introduction... and promotion for the cigar, for General Cigar. So, yeah.
That'll be nice.
A lot of people, we passed out 200 keys. We have a Macanudo humidor with 20 cigars, Churchill's, which is $200 retail.
Wow.
So we're giving all that away October 3rd here.
That'll be cool.
Yeah.
I'll be there.
Okay. We can
we'll
take a
in.
Break and come back shortly, huh?
With Sounds like a plan.
First tour.
We'll do it.
All right.
We will return.
We'll be right back.
That's about right, yeah.
Yeah. We're back.
We are back.
With our second tour, the Tom and Ed Show. And what do you think so far?
It's a, I wouldn't call it a full-bodied cigar just yet, but it's probably
it's
upper.
Full.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Why am I thinking upper medium?
Full. Yeah.
Yeah.
Are you trying to argue with
me? Yeah, I am.
You.
But
it's full.
I like it so far. I mean,
so far, I get the same thing you get.
Well, yeah, like a slight earth, a slight
the
pepper.
Slight earth still in there, slight pepper.
I mean, it's all subtle, though. Nothing's...
A little cocoa in there.
See, and that's why I was thinking upper medium, because everything's subtle.
Yeah, and I also get a touch of walnut, which is, you know, a nice flat taste. Just above the earth.
I definitely can't. Yeah, I can't dispute the nutty.
Yeah.
Nutty
touch.
Notes.
Yeah.
But that's what led me to believe it was maybe upper medium, because nothing is like
take
intense.
A nice,
you know what I mean?
Take a nice draw and
I'll
really
let it, cool
let it out through your nose.
Okay. I'm going to let it cool down a little. I just took a puff.
Okay.
But so far, the first third went well.
Burns very nice. We don't have no breeze out here this morning.
Yeah.
But
I only had minor. Nothing to even talk about.
Right.
Nothing
and the wrapper feels a touch oily, you know what I mean, which is good.
And it looks a little.
Yeah.
And speaking of that, we were talking to Walt during our break.
Right.
And he got some info, I'll just quote.
Oh, that's right. He did a...
from smokeshopmag.com, Walt just gave me some quotes, which says, additionally, in one of General Cigar's warehouses, one discovers over 16,000 Tercios... airtight bales of tightly wrapped palm leaves used for aging wrappers, binders, and fillers.
So that means probably stitched.
Right. So Walt says it sounds like they wrap.
Yeah.
They wrap it in palm leaves and allow it to age in barrels.
And they probably stitch them.
Charcoal
barrels. So Tercios probably, which means stitched in Spanish.
Yeah, and your brother.
I just found out.
Your brother.
It's not my brother. It's I call him brother, just like I call you brother.
Oh, yeah. Awesome.
It's Gary Sanchez. Yeah, from the store down there. Anyhow, he thought it meant stitched, you know. So and it sounds like it is now.
Because Ed and I were trying to figure out what they mean by aged inter seals
right.
and charcoal wooden barrels. We didn't
so
that
would
that.
Be little so. Stitched bundles and put into the barrels.
Maybe that would give everybody a clue as to what the hell Macanudo is talking about when they
right.
say that. The quote, because the quote I gave, I said in the first section, was right from Macanudo's website.
Yeah.
Okay. And I didn't understand it.
Right.
And neither did you.
Mm-mm.
So thanks, Walt, for helping us out during our break. That's cool. Very nice of him.
Still tastes very, very nice. And it's, you know what? Why you think it's on the milder side?
Well, medium, upper medium.
Yeah, but you know why?
Why?
It's a very smooth cigar.
Good point. And so, but I just exhaled through the nose like you suggested.
What do you think?
And I see where you're coming from.
Yeah.
I just got a big hit of cocoa.
Cocoa, yeah.
So
that's, yeah.
So, I could see where you're coming from.
Right.
But I'm impressed with it.
Me too.
So
I really enjoy it. It's a very, very enjoyable taste in here.
Pretty damn good. And see, I just got another big hit of cocoa on that one.
Yeah.
So maybe I'm going through some kind of change.
And
in
I'm
the
still
cigar.
Getting a little walnut in here.
Yeah, and just slight spices and.
Yeah.
So it's a pretty complex cigar as well.
Yeah,
in my opinion.
Absolutely. Yeah.
This is probably the most impressive.
It's got a very nice draw. You know about yours?
Yeah, the draw is perfect in my opinion. It's a slight
draw is perfect.
Little resistance.
Yeah, very slight.
But not enough to.
Right. Exactly.
It's what I consider perfect.
It's a pretty tight cigar.
Yeah.
Not spongy at all.
Nope.
So.
No. Like a sheen look to it, like a oily.
Right.
It's nice.
So if you guys see the 1968 Macanudo, give it a try. It's a little pricey, but it's worth it. I think it's worth it. I've smoked the same priced cigars and didn't think much of them, so.
So far, I'm happy with it.
Yeah.
And how long have we been on? Maybe we should we wrap up this segment or should
we
go
can.
On?
Yeah, we mentioned
we did the Tercios thing and all that. That was our main dilemma, was the Tercios and what does it mean?
Right.
So it's Tercios and charcoal wooden barrels.
Yeah.
And it's aged in that.
But all in all, so far, so good, guys. And we're going to go do the second tour and we shall come right back. Back, guys, with our second third.
Second third is complete, basically.
Yeah.
For the most part.
Yeah.
Ed's smoking a little quick today.
Yeah, for some reason. I don't know why, but.
I usually have to slow down or,
Well, normally I have customers, so I don't smoke as much as quickly
true.
As you.
That's true.
But,
good point.
Yeah.
But for some reason, you're smoking a little quicker, so I figured.
I like it.
So. There you have it.
Very consistent on the taste. I had a little addition in the second tour, a little bit of coffee in here. And I don't know if, did you get any coffee?
A little bit.
Yeah.
But, you know, mocha has been taking over for me, for the most part. A lot of mocha. Yeah,
The coffee is pretty strong here, a little bit, along with a touch of chocolate and I have no earthness in here anymore.
No, the earthness went away. Earthy taste went away for me
the
a while ago.
The spice increases just a touch.
Bit.
Yeah.
Right in the nose.
Right there, yeah.
And I definitely have to agree, if you blow the smoke through your nose now, it's in the full body range.
Yeah.
But just through the mouth, it might be deceptive to you because it's so smooth. You know what I'm, if that makes sense?
Yeah.
So it's...
But you do.
Yeah.
It is full body.
Yeah.
And it's burning real nice.
I'm happy with this Macanudo.
Yeah.
1968. And trying to think of any other flavors I might have left out. I don't think I've gotten any woody flavors
No.
yet.
A little bit of nutty in there.
Yeah.
A little touch of nuts. Yeah. The walnut is pretty much going. That was... I was getting that when we were getting a little bit of the earthness in there.
Right.
And it picked up a little bit in walnut, and now it's pretty much going. But it's still got a little nutty in here, and I would say maybe a little almondy, you know.
Yeah, I can't identify
distinct.
That.
Yeah.
I can identify a slight nuttiness, but I can't, as usual, I can't say it's almonds or Brazilian nuts or whatever, you know, I can't do that yet.
But you don't eat enough of them.
That's true.
You got to eat them to get the taste out of it.
That's true. And the burn has been good. I've been correcting a little bit, but a lot of that is because of me being really picky about an even burn
Mine's
line.
Been pretty
Yours
even.
Is perfect. You haven't
perfect.
Had to do
it. Yeah, nice burn.
Mine has been within acceptable range. I always fiddle with my cigar and touch them up. So I can't fault
did
that cigar.
You said something about, was it Jerry did a... Oh. A text.
Actually, Brian. Oh yeah, Brian Hewitt.
Brian did it, huh?
Did a written review on this cigar just recently.
Yeah. Did you read it?
I didn't read it in detail because I didn't want to.
Did he mention any?
I read
coffee,
the caption.
Chocolate. Any
I didn't get into it that much.
No. Okay.
Just because I wanted to see how.
We did it.
Yeah. When I get home today, I'm going to read it.
Okay.
But I'd like to compare it. Unbiased. Like I don't want to. Have influence from
exactly.
his review, so
that's good. Yeah.
So I'm hoping they're similar. You know, I mean, I read his end caption, mm-hmm. which basically said he
liked
it.
And for you guys out there that want to try the Macanudo, go to your local shops where they giving away the humidor keys, and if you are a winner, if your key fits the humidor, you get an additional box of cigars at Churchill's, which is. Retails for $200 off.
I'll take a picture and
it's a $400. I sent you the picture on your email.
Oh yeah, that's right.
The whole picture.
I'll put the picture right here.
Yeah, right. I mean, it's a nice deal, and you can go back to your local shop that day. You get a free cigar, you get some snacks, you get some refreshments, and pretty neat what they did. Very nice.
They are doing a nice promotion.
But nice promotion.
And maybe I should take a picture of your.
Yeah, take a picture of that.
Neon,
that's
or not
pretty
neon,
nice.
But, and I can put that.
Yeah,
right here.
It's a pretty nice sign that they made. Yeah,
so they're doing up the promotion and
very very nicely done. Yeah.
So far, rightfully so. This is.
Yeah. Yeah.
I mean, like for their other lines, I don't know. I'm not a big fan of them.
No.
So, but so far this
they're mild cigars, very nice.
They're good. You
know? Yeah.
Yeah. I mean,
good.
I'm not certainly not saying they're bad.
Right. Exactly.
But they're not worth the price. I guess is what I'm getting at. For a cigar of that price, you could get something else.
Yeah.
But
I mean, if you like a full body.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or even like a good.
Because
mild.
They're very light.
Yeah,
they're pretty mild.
One dimensional as well.
Yeah.
Whereas like the Port Larryunga.
Yeah.
Mild body, full of flavor.
Full of flavor.
Blah blah blah.
Yeah.
You know, cheap, half the price.
Yeah.
So.
No, about the same price.
Really?
Yeah.
The vintage? Those are like 15 bucks.
Oh, the vintage, yeah. No, the vintage
they're
is
like
different.
15,
yeah.
20 bucks.
20 bucks, yeah.
And I know people who smoke those exclusively.
I got you. I'm talking about the regular Macanudos.
Regular Macanudos. Yeah. I've only had experience with the vintage.
Yeah.
And I've smoked a lot of them
mm-hmm.
when I started out.
Yeah, you bought some from me.
Yeah, and they were a good starter cigar.
Yeah.
But anyway, that's not important, I guess. Yeah. But as far as the first and second third of this thing.
This is very, very, it's only going to get better. This is our second third, and the last third of the cigar, it's going to get even better. And it increases into a completely full body. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it then. Yeah. I don't think I've had this size. I've had other sizes of this.
Yeah.
And
I myself only had the Robusto in the past.
Right.
And loved it.
And that's probably an $8 cigar, right? The Robusto.
$8.50, yeah.
So it's a little high, but as I was talking
about. But it's worth it, you know, to at least try one time.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
And we're joined by MJ here from thecigarspy.com.
Yeah, okay.
He's joined us on Stick'Em.
Yeah.
So I'm talking to him. We've been talking to him about it.
To him, yeah.
But he hasn't tried it, so.
Yeah. And you guys can always view our critiques in StogieReview.com.
Always, yeah.
TomCigar.com. And at my website also.
StPetePipeCigars.com?
Yeah.
Or on our Miro channel, M-I-R-O.
StPetePipeCigars.com, yep. Correct. Yeah.
I'm actually going to make a page on your site that just has video.
Yeah.
Sounds good. That'll be cool. Then the people, your local guys can go to your site.
And they get familiar with other sites, which, gives them a lot of views,
Exactly.
For the cigar smoker, I think that'll help a lot of the cigar smokers, especially some of the beginners.
That's why we're doing it.
Yep.
That's why I got you on the internet.
Oh, is that why?
That for the enjoyment of fine cigars.
And here I was thinking that you want to make a nectar out of me.
No. So yeah, that's.
Damn it.
First and second, third, I'm not saying it's the best cigar or the worst cigar, but I'm pretty impressed with it.
It's a very nice cigar.
I mean, of course, there's better cigars out there, but this is damn good so far.
Yeah. I've smoked much more expensive and actually not worth it at all.
Yeah, a lot less.
Exactly.
And of course, I've done the opposite.
And the opposite, absolutely.
So I guess we should dig in, right?
Okay. We're going to do our last third here in a few minutes, and we'll be back very shortly with our last third.
Yep. Sounds like a plan.
Got it. Keep on puffing, guys.
Have returned for the final third.
Okay.
135 minutes of smoking.
Wow. Very good.
On this nice cigar.
So, what do you think of the last third?
It's definitely full bodied.
Okay.
Some nice spice. Nice cocoa and coffee, I think.
Coffee, cocoa, cinnamon, almond. Really, really got complex here the last third. Absolutely.
Yeah, as always, and that's why you're here, because you got more than I did.
On 1 to 10, what would you give this cigar?
I'd have to give it a 7.5. 8, I think, is a little generous because of the price.
I think I would give it a 7, which is very, very, I would say it's very good.
But, and strangely enough.
Yeah, we had Anthony came over late this morning.
Yeah, we were hoping he could join us for the review.
And he has had about 3 or 4 of these cigars.
Yes, I have.
So, let me give Anthony the microphone here. And what do you think of this freaking smoke? Quick little summary,
I think it's the best Mac Nudo I have ever had. It's a really good full-body cigar. I recommend it to anybody that's a full-bodied cigar smoker.
Definitely.
I agree. It's full of flavor. You get lots of flavor out of it.
So you're impressed with it?
Oh, I am very impressed with it. It's a really good cigar.
Cool.
What would you rate it at?
What do you think?
You don't have to agree with us.
Yeah, you disagree if you feel like it.
Well, my rating, let's see.
It's kind of tough.
You know what? I'd actually give it pretty much a 10 because it's...
No shit.
10,
no, 10 is,
or maybe a 9.
I could take 9. 9 is a valid opinion.
9, 10.
9 is an invalid opinion.
No,
in my
it's valid.
Opinion.
Why? What did you say?
No.
Why is that?
Oh, I fight.
So many other cigars are a lot better.
Oh, I know, but I'm just saying for.
Don't forget, this is a Churchill, and it's an $11 cigar.
A fight here on camera, folks.
So.
Yeah.
Well, it's his opinion, though.
Yeah.
I mean, 10 being perfect. So obviously, really perfect.
Like I said, it's a really good cigar. I mean, it's cool. I get cinnamon, I get notes of sweet, semi-sweet cocoa in it.
Yep.
I get
coffee.
I get lots of coffee out of it. But you know what? I mean, it is right though. I mean, really, I have smoked about three or four of them.
To give a 10 to a cigar, it has to be absolutely perfect.
Right, get an honest opinion.
Gotcha.
But I still think it's a great cigar, no matter what, without rating it even. It's still a great cigar. I mean,
Nothing wrong with that. Yeah. That's cool. Yeah,
there is other, like you said, there is
other cigars that are so much better.
There is other cigars that are so much better, but it's a for Macanudo.
Oh yeah, yeah.
It's a great cigar.
Yeah. If you were to compare it to other, compared to other Macanudos, man, this is the shit.
The Macanudo 1968 is their strongest cigar ever made.
Yep.
As it, I don't know if it's been mentioned.
Yeah. Oh, well, maybe not. Maybe not. I don't know.
I just got to let everyone know. I'm really late getting here. I was at a show last night. Didn't get home.
That don't matter. You'll be here for the next one.
Didn't get home till 4 o'clock in the morning. Woke up late, so I totally forgot.
It's all good.
But I'm glad you two got to have me here and everything for the little bit that I have.
Absolutely, man. And you'll be joining. Oh, go ahead. Sorry.
Yeah, and I'll be joining for the next cigar review.
Which
most
is?
Most definitely, hopefully.
Which is going to be?
Go ahead.
It'll be the Gurkha Black Dragon.
Yep.
Yep.
Damn fine smoke. Maybe. Damn fine. But maybe it's not. Maybe we'll hate it. No, I'm just kidding.
Oh, I like that cigar. But,
yeah.
So without further ado, I just want to say to all the viewers out there, keep on puffing.
Cool, man. Thanks for stopping by.
No problem.
I shut it off there. Thank you. But
that was okay.
That was awesome.
Absolutely.
That's a cameo appearance with Anthony there.
Well, see, I mean, you're right about that. Well, I mean...
No, you're good. But anyway, thumbs up.
Oh, absolutely.
And...
For you viewers out there, go get one if you at your local shop. You'll absolutely enjoy the cigar.
I like
it. No question about it.
And what do you think about somebody brought up pairing drinks with cigars? I know you do coffee a lot and water, which I do as well.
And I have done the.
But I like alcoholic beverages.
Grand Marnier. And now you brought this. This scotch here, which I hate scotch, but I'll tell you what. This is something really, really special.
Yeah, it's the Glenlivet.
Just enough to scrub around your mouth in there, and I'm telling you, it brings out great tastes in a cigar. It really cleans up your palate.
It's like a reset button.
Yeah.
For your palate, this what Ed's talking about is this Glenlivet single malt Scotch whiskey, aged 12 years.
12 years old. Wow.
I did a little blurb on this on my blog, TomCigars.com, but. Yeah. Because I don't drink, and you can read.
I don't drink, but I would use that as a palate cleaner, and your palates will
just a small.
The notes just come right up nice.
Yeah, yeah. It really does.
Very clean.
Yeah. I never would have thought of it if I didn't get this as a gift.
Yeah.
So like, and do you pair any other drinks,
No, I've never done any others.
Like rum or anything, or
no, never.
You're just not a big.
Just the Grand Marnier, which has got a citrusy flavor, and it also helps clean up your palates very, very nicely. So,
cool.
Yeah.
Cool. I just wanted to touch on that because there's a lot of drinks out there that.
Yeah.
Can help with your.
Absolutely.
With your smoking.
These
experience.
Are not the only ones, of course. Yeah.
No. But I mean, I always default to water.
Yeah.
That's about all I got with that, but
water is not bad either.
And it doesn't get you in trouble or root beer. Anthony likes root beer. I mean everybody has different tastes. Some people like
root
Coke.
Root beer is not bad either.
Yeah.
I like root beer.
Some people like Coke.
Some Coke, like I can't see.
Some like Sprite. I mean
So
that Dr. Pepper even, Actually, I've seen Jerry from Stogie Review drink Dr. Pepper.
Dr. Pepper is not bad either, yeah.
So,
anyways, you have anything else to say about?
Not really. I guess coming up, as you heard with Anthony, the Gurkha, but.
Yeah, we'll do the Gurkha Black Dragon
soon,
next time.
One of these days, we're hooking
up. A couple
of
weeks, we'll do it, yeah.
And we're hooking up with Jerry one of these days for a joint cigar review.
Yeah, yeah, that sounds good.
And also Justin from Las Vegas TV. Okay. We're joining up with him.
Let's do.
One of these days
for
a get-together.
I'd like that.
And all cool guys. And that's about it.
How are you doing?
That's the happenings besides your Macanudo event, October 3rd at 10 a.m. to 8 p.m.
right?
If you're in the area, stop by.
Yeah, refreshments, snacks, free cigar. Come on down.
Just a BS session, hanging out.
Yeah.
We got
plenty of seats now, so don't be bashful.
Yep. Stop on by.
And with that, we're gonna call it quits here for the day.
I think we're good for the Macanudo 1968.
Yeah. And we'll see you next time. Keep on buffing. Hey, you're saying that pretty well, huh? Keep on puffing, guys.
Keep on puffing. Keep on puffing, motherfucker.
Hey.
Oh, Anthony, what's up?
Anthony,
man?
You're late.
I forgot. Listen, I get at 4 o'clock last night.
Next one, man, we're going to.
What the hell are you doing on my.
It's all good.
O'clock?
Well, what we'll do, next one, we'll do
cheating
a girth.
Cheating on your girlfriend?